I don't know if any one of you knows this book. It's Linda Gretton. It's kind of an oldie. It's written in 2011. It's called The Shift. The future of work is already here. And she describes the changes, the shift in work due to technology, globalization, and energy resources. And the interesting thing about this book is that she gives us two scenarios, two options. One is the downside option, and that means that through all the shifts in work, the platforms, we end up in a very, very ugly society. She calls it a three-minute society where everyone goes from little kick to little kick, waiting for a job or not. She describes a society with a lot of loneliness because everyone's on their own, struggling for their own, working not any longer from offices but only from their own houses. A society with a lot of exclusion, a lot of working poor, and a few people who have it all. But there's also a different option, and that's the upside. And that means that due to technology, globalization, etc., there's a world with a lot of co-creation, where knowledge, work is accessible for everyone, and everyone has its or her share of it. We'll be able, way more than a decade ago, to bring ideas together. It's a society where there's plenty of room for social engagement, so you can organize your work the way you want it, so you have time off for taking care of relatives, for volunteer work, things like that. And it's a society with a lot of entrepreneurship, micro-entrepreneurs, for example. Well, that's the upside. And in my opinion, we are right now on a crossroad, and we can choose if we want to leave everything come like it comes, and then we end up right in the ugly world, or we can stick together and find out how we can blend in the new world and the old world together. Because, in my opinion, the old world wasn't as bad as people might think now. It's not logic for people now to work 40 years, 40 hours a week for the same employer. But other things like our social security, it's very worthful, and it gives, now in the Netherlands, there's not a lot of difference between the rich and the poor. So we have to blend the new and the old world and bring the good things of the old world into the new world. And at this moment, there is not a real place where we can find the right checks and balances, and it's mainly the owners of the platforms that set their own rules for the people working for them, and that has to change. For example, the ratings. Yeah? If you are working for Uber and your ratings tell them that you're always in time and very friendly, well, if you want to go to Helpling, it's nice that you can bring your ratings from Uber to Helpling. But who's the owner of the ratings? Is that the worker or is it the platform? Those are questions we have to answer. And we know pretty good what the platforms want, but there's a gap. And we don't know right good enough what the gig workers want. And that's why I'm so glad today that we can discuss together and that the gig workers themselves can tell us what it feels to be a gig worker. Does it make you happy? Does it cause stress? So I hope that you'll tell us the whole story and not only the political correct answers. Thank you.